spend more time on Facebook suffer higher rates of depression than people who spend less time on Facebook. It'll destroy relationships, it'll cost time, and it'll cost money, and it'll make your life worse.
To be human means that you are persuadable in every single moment. It doesn't matter what language you speak, it doesn't matter how intelligent you are, it's not about what someone knows, it's about how your mind actually works.
We now know that many of the major social media companies hire individuals called attention engineers who borrow principles from Las Vegas casino gambling, among other places, to try to make these products as addictive as possible.
We are all vulnerable to social approval. We really care what other people think of us. When you upload a new photo of yourself on Facebook, that's a moment where our mind is very vulnerable to knowing what other people think of my new profile photo. And so when we get new likes on our profile photo, Facebook, knowing this, could actually message me and say, oh, you have new likes on your profile photo. It knows that we'll be vulnerable to that moment because we all really care about when we're tagged in a photo or when we have a new profile photo. I mean, I think we can all feel it. And it's as if we've been infected. It's as if they've drilled a hole in the back of our head and now they've injected the virus and now we walk around searching for feedback using social media.
We know that engagement with social media and our cell phones releases a chemical called dopamine. Dopamine is the exact same chemical that makes us feel good when we smoke, when we drink, and when we gamble. In other words, it's highly, highly addictive. You have an entire generation that has access to an addictive, numbing chemical called dopamine through social media and cell phones as they're going through the high stress. They don't have the coping mechanisms to deal with stress. So when significant stress starts to show up in their lives, they're not turning to a person, they're turning to social media. They're turning to these things which offer temporary relief. We know, the science is clear, we know that people who spend more time on Facebook suffer higher rates of depression than people who spend less time on Facebook. That's a problem. That's an addiction. If you're sitting in a meeting with people you're supposed to be listening to and speaking, and you put your phone on the table, you're just not that important to me. Right?
So you have an addicted generation that doesn't have the skill set to ask for help, combined with the fact that they're so good at Facebook and Instagram, they're good at putting filters on everything. So they're good at showing you how smart and strong they are. These kids who commit suicide, you go look at their Instagrams, you would have no clue that they were depressed.
People look like they have a much better life than they really do. People are posting pictures of when they're really happy. They're modifying those pictures to be better looking. People basically seem they're way better looking than they basically really are, and they're way happier seeming than they really are. So if you look at everyone on Instagram, you might think, they're all these happy, beautiful people, and I'm not that good looking and I'm not happy, so I'm a suck. Some of the happiest seeming people, actually some of the saddest people in reality.
Social media isn't real, but you don't ever see real life. The 99% of our lives, the behind the scenes, the unglamorous, unfiltered, day-to-day, bland normality. And you end up comparing your behind the scenes to other people's fake highlight reel and using others as a mirror or benchmark for how you should look, how successful you should be, or how you should live. You'll become your happier self when you stop putting pressure on yourself to be more like someone else.
And they know that this causes depression. They're injecting things into your head that you didn't ask for. Our lives are becoming more transparent, just inevitably, it's just pulling us.
It'll destroy relationships, it'll cost time, and it'll cost money, and it'll make your life worse.
On Christmas Day, I saw three ships come sailing in on Christmas Day in the morning.
Blah, blah, blah.
Unless you've been living under a rock during the past few months, you've probably heard of TikTok. It's the short-form-based video platform that has taken the world by storm. It's incredibly entertaining, but what you probably didn't know is that by using TikTok, you are at a serious risk of taking years off of your life. While it might seem like just a fun way to pass time, the app is actually extremely dangerous for your health and well-being. In order to get you to use TikTok for extended periods of time, the creators of the app have designed it to be as addicting as humanly possible. And the way that it rewrites your brain during extended use will actually take years off of your life. Here's how. When I ask you, what is a drug? Your mind probably quickly jumps to the idea of cigarettes or pills, and that's normal, because that's what your teachers and the media have conditioned you to think when you hear that word. But those answers aren't exactly what we're looking for. Those are just examples. Step one of understanding why TikTok is dangerous to your health is for you to realize that the dangers of a drug has to do with the addictiveness associated with releases of dopamine. In case you didn't already know, dopamine is a type of neurotransmitter. Your body makes it, and your nervous system uses it to send messages between nerve cells. Dopamine plays a role in how we feel pleasure. It's a big part in our uniquely human ability to think and plan ahead. If I were to ask you what drug causes the most deaths every year, you'd probably say cigarettes.
Come on, son. You want some? Come get some. Oh! Soon. Okay, Frank. Appreciate it.
It's a good guess, and one that over 95% of people make. But the correct answer is actually sugar. Unhealthy eating, characterized by high consumption of sugar-sweetened foods and beverages, contribute to more deaths than any other factor, because they contribute towards heart disease.
Buenos dias, amigo. Si, me llamo car breakdown, and I'm over here in the Croton by the cornfields, and I need a ride, man. My van break down. I don't know. No, seriously, I don't know what happened. I replaced the alternator, I don't know, 2-3 days ago, and it just literally shut off on me. So, okay. No, that's cool, man. I mean, honestly, if, okay, no, dang it. No, I understand. Yeah. No, last thing I wanted to do was do that, but it looks like I'm going to have to.
Uber.
Okay. All right. See ya. Bye. Dang it.
Hello?
We got influencers out in the wild. We gotta make a new compilation video. She's just doing weights on Rodeo 2. Oh, she stopped.
Dude, that's pretty impressive.
Dude.
Shh. Aaron, shh. We got this Range Rover and then.
Yo, they got cash.
Yeah, don't go over there.
You weren't joking.
Yeah. Like, get this kid.
Oh, it's like a music video. It's a music video. Because they got the guy recording. They're playing like a song. Oh, they got the cash. He's got the fanny pack.
Quite the spectacle here on Rodeo Drive, ladies and gentlemen.
Yo, what the f-
Uber.
Going on here? Nice! I mean, honestly, the footage just speaks for itself, doesn't it? At this point, like, I don't have to even say anything.
Whoa! Oh! Yes, sir! Oh, and he's blocking the girl! Whoa! Oh, little twirl! These guys are all riled up!
This guy is just balling out on top of this police,
Yo,
he's got stacks.
We got people doing music videos on Rodeo Drive, flexing on the Jeep. There we go.
I heard that's actually really hard to do, cause the elastic band is really is not easy to stretch. I'm just saying, like, it's not easy to do. Oh, he's done. He's done his reps. He's got it.
What the hell is going over here?
What the
f- Uber.
This is straight up influencers in the wild. This guy's got moves though. He's got moves.
Look at his shoes. He's still got tags on his shoes.
Oh, respect, dude.
Driver TikTok.
Yo, check this out. I'm gonna give this guy a ride.
You don't come on.
Let's get it.
I got 450 likes right now. TikTok, get in. You need a ride? Come on. Let's go. Get in. TikTok.
Are you sure it's safe to do that later?
Oh, yeah,
you
man.
Like a million views?
Let's go.
A million views right now.
TikTok.
Some people can't afford to get a nice car.
This is my truck that I pick people up. You know what I'm saying?
TikTok is where you want to see me. Uber Daisy in the house, driving all over the place. This is TikTok Daisy in the house. Yeah, you like that? That's what I'm talking about.
Full round for nothing, you know.
Yeah.
I ain't doing this for nothing. I need the likes. I need everything I can get, okay? I ain't doing this for nothing. All right.
TikTok! Yeah! Yo, get out!
Okay.
Get up out of here!
the spot.
Thanks for the drive.
Yeah, man. Yeah, call me.
Hey, good luck with your good luck with that TikTok.
Yeah, you bet. There's a billion views right now.
Crazy.
This is due to the release of dopamine associated with the sugar in the chocolate. It makes you feel good. It makes you want more. TikTok works in the exact same way. Listen up, because this next part is important. What I'm about to say could save your life. What I'm about to share with you is what TikTok is really doing to your brain and how you can stop it.
Hey, Jackson, boy, how you doing, buddy? He's a good boy. He's a good boy. Yes, you are.
Tom?
What's time at, buddy?
Tom?
Hey, buddy.
So, what if I told you that I had one of those TikToker kids in the crawl space of one of my properties? Hey, what would you say if I told you that I had one of those TikTok kids in one...
Yo!
Yo, what's poppin', homie?
Hey, what's going on?
Nothing.
Check this out. I just made this stand not too long ago to hold all this paint.
Ooh, look at that. So what do? Just like pull something and it lifts it up, or is it just suspended?
No, it can be adjusted.
I like that a lot. Who helped you out with that? Or did you do it all your lonesomes?
I had to do my lonesomes. You was too busy, dude. Yeah, I mean, shoot.
I love it.
Hard.
Hey, is it cool if I grab a beer?
Yeah, man. You know, that's fine
with me. Well, I'll tell you something funny. You might laugh or cry, but let me ask your thoughts about something. So I'm driving, I'm working, right? And, my car breaks down.
Is this gonna be long for?
No, it's not gonna be too long, but check this out. So my car breaks down. I gotta get a lift.
Yeah.
And so I get a lift and the guy picks me up and we're driving. And you know, I don't know how you feel about this stuff, but I get in the car. And the guy has his phone out. He's got like two phones, or maybe he has one phone, but so
they usually have like one
for the
app and then another personal one.
Right. Okay. So he's driving the car and he's all up in his phone. Like he's clicking away at different things and doing stuff, and I'm trying to talk to him, but he's very like there's no reciprocity. It's just he's in his own world, and I found it kind of frustrating, you know.
Yeah.
And I don't know what your opinion is on this. No. Like, if you can give me your 100% opinion, I feel like this tech stuff, these social media and all this fun stuff, and then now you got the metaverse coming out, and it's like these people are so immersed in their stuff that you can't even, like, it seems like you can't even really talk to a real human being anymore.
I know.
At least a stranger, you know. It's like, hey, we can talk, we can chit chat, but
yeah, people cannot carry on conversations.
Yeah,
not even small talk.
Right,
because it's like a dying art. I mean,
that's a good way to put it. It's almost like a dying art. That's actually kind of true. Kind of like handwriting, or what would you call it? Penmanship.
Yeah.
It's like people don't have penmanship anymore because nobody writes. I've been noticing that more and more more and more often than not, when I go to places, I usually see people. I mean, you know, when you go to a restaurant or a bar or something, it's, or even just anywhere, you see people always on their devices, you know, like especially when you go to a, like a restaurant or something, it's like, it's not long before you see everybody, the whole family, right? It's just, there's the talk's done and now it's, hey, cell phone time out and that's it.
Mm-hmm. I mean, it's like, it's crazy because society has made such a joke out of people, you know, using their devices at like Saturday Night Live and all those shows that are doing jokes on reality. You know, they have the family that's around a dinner table and they're texting each other, and you have the brother and sister that are across the table texting each other, you know, not only people outside but themselves, you know. And it's like, we've made fun of it so much that it's become like humorous and not serious that we do it, and that's when people are actually still doing it. Like, we all do that, and we don't understand what it does, you know, the harm that it does, because we're so it's funny to us. We don't take it serious.
I remember when the the selfie was like,
oh my gosh,
a really weird looking thing. I remember seeing people take selfies or see footage of people taking selfies, and it was the like weirdest thing. You looked at somebody and you were like, how could you be so like conceited or ego or what would you call that?
Self-absorbed,
right?
Yeah.
And it was so weird looking. Like, why would you hold a phone out and take your own photo, like, you know, or like video by yourself? Usually, always, 100% of the time.
Usually, always,
100% of the time.
Well, listen.
Somebody else would do it. You'd be like, hey, can you take a photo of me?
Yeah.
You'd be like, cool. That'd be the norm.
Yeah.
But now it's like, hey, I don't need anybody.
Well, you'd even be involving somebody. Ouch! Mm-hmm. In that situation. Well, dang it. It's like, at one point, people were taking selfies and they felt this cringe, like, oh man, like, I can't believe I'm doing this, but I need to do it for my self-image. Mm-hmm. Now it's to the point where people don't care if people are watching them, because nobody's judging.
Right.
So they think, I'm judging.
Right, exactly. So, yeah, and that's kind of been my frustration, you know. Lately, you know, we kind of grew up in a time where, I mean, we grew up in a time where that didn't exist.
Yeah.
But now it's like, it's so thrust upon us for the past 5-10 years. It's become the norm. It's the culture now. It's ingrained in the culture. So we don't think much of it, but I still see it. And so anyway, I took this ride with this guy and that was it. And, you know, it got me frustrated, I'll be honest.
Yeah, you said that.
Yeah. And so, kid you not, dude, I'm driving in my car the other day, right? Mm-hmm. You with me on this?
Yeah, yep.
Okay, so I'm driving in my car the other day.
It's usually what you do in your car.
It's usually what you do in your car. You're driving. Mm-hmm. And I look to the side of the street and I see this kid, I don't know, Gen Z-er for sure. And he's got this tripod.
And dude, I kid you not, like, no joke. I take this kid.
So you're not joking?
No joke. I lure him over to my van.
What, candy?
Hey, buddy, come here. Get in my van.
And
but you're
dude, I kid you not.
You're not kidding.
I have the slide door open. Okay.
Well, of course you would.
I have the slide door open, and I get him to like step into it because I'm giving him some like bull.
This sounds like a scene from a movie, dude.
And Tom, I'm not gonna lie to you, dude. Once he's like leaning into my van, I push him in, I lock the door, and I got him in my van, and I start driving. I'm not joking. I start driving.
Uh-huh.
And I'm kind of in shock. I don't know what's really going on, but
you're kind of the shock that you would have if you just threw a kid in the van. Yeah, I don't know what that shock would be like, but I imagine.
Okay.
I imagine you would be in shock.
But he can't get out because I got the door locked because you can't open it from the inside. I had the like child thing on.
Yeah,
and I'm kind of panicked. He's smaller than me, so I'm not too worried about him like overpowering me or nothing. So.
Oh, good. That's good.
Yeah.
You picked a good one.
Yeah.
So.
Skinny Gen Zers on the vet, you know. Where you want to go for it? You're going to be kidding that
right,
one.
Right.
Yeah. So you
the,
got
the vegetarians. You want the vegetarians.
You want them? Aren't they all? You want them?
So
you want them skinny?
Look, I take him to this. I have a property, right, that I'm selling. It's vacant.
Yeah, the one out in Apple Valley?
Exactly. I take him there, and I tie him up, duct tape him, and...
This sounds premeditated. Where did this duct tape come from?
Dude, I put him in the crawl space in the house.
Okay.
And he's there right now.
Yeah.
So...
Did you feed him?
Huh?
Did you feed him? How long has he been there?
Well, I haven't got that far yet, but...
Oh my gosh. All right, where are you going with this?
So, I feel like there was a purpose here, and I think what I want to do is kind of teach the kid a lesson, you know, like show him like the simpler ways of living. Like this stuff didn't always exist, right? Your social medias and your virtual worlds and all that crap. It didn't used to exist, and we got along just fine. And I'm thinking, maybe, just maybe, we can, by teaching this kid a lesson, it'll kind of bleed out and teach all the other Gen Zers and the generations to come a lesson.
Yeah.
And
I mean, it'll definitely hit the news.
Yeah. So, look, in a hypothetical situation, if I came down here, I mean, because look, we're kind of on the same vibe here. Like, you agree with me that the Gen Zers and the millennials, anybody who's into the... anybody who's
shoot
into,
them.
Submersed so much in that world needs a little bit of a lesson.
They need a little lesson.
Would you like an opportunity to teach a lesson to one?
I would teach them a lesson. Give me an opportunity.
Give me an opportunity? Okay.
These are always hypothetical.
Yeah, okay. So what if I told you that if I came down here and you're sitting here doing your thing, you know, like you're busy and all, and I say, hey, Tom, legitimately 100%, I have a Gen Zer in the crawl space in my property up north. He's bound up and yeah. What would you say?
I would say I don't believe you.
Okay.
But if you kept insisting and were serious, I'd say prove it.
Prove it?
Yeah.
Let's see. Do you have time for a little road trip?
Yeah.
You got any cigars?
I do.
All right.
Let's go.
Let's go. You brought the cutter and the lighter?
Yep. Oh, man. What a beautiful day to be doing something illegal.
Not illegal. Since when was getting educated illegal?
I mean, I guess you do have to pay for it. This is something I think we're going to pay for, though.
Oh my gosh, look. See, this is what I'm talking about. You get these kids, man. It's not just kids, but adults too. And look at them. This is it. This is all that matters right now. It's the internet. And that kid right there, I gotta go back. I'm gonna go back man. I don't know. I'm just going to talk to him. I'm not what I think I am. I'm not what you think I am. I am what I think you think I am.
Hey, man, what are you doing? You tick? You TikToking?
Yeah. That's cool.
I have a ring light, a couple of ring lights. Do you want them? I don't need them anymore.
Free? Yeah, free. Yeah, just come to the side door. I'll unlock it for you. I'm gonna steal you forever.
Yeah, it's just back there.
It's just right in the corner there, buddy.
This is your brain, and this is your brain after spending just 10 minutes watching TikToks. And that's not a mistake. The people who programmed TikTok made it this way because it keeps you watching. The app is designed to keep you glued to the screen for as long as possible. Using TikTok is the same thing as drugging yourself. You'll remain in a pleasurable and dopamine-filled state, continuously being carried along by what comes next, always craving another video. It's almost hypnotic. You keep watching and watching, scrolling and scrolling. Have you ever noticed that the app hides what time it is? That's not a mistake. You'll waste an entire hour scrolling, only to shake your head and wonder where all that time had gone. When you're scrolling, sometimes you see something funny or something that's exciting and it catches your attention. You get that little dopamine hit to the pleasure center of your brain. So you want to keep scrolling. Every few seconds, there's something else to grab your attention. And you will keep scrolling because sometimes you see something you like.
I think we're good. Hey, I got some cigars right there. If you want to get those suckers started, that'd be fantastic. I got a couple Arturo Fuentes, and I forget the name of those, but what are they?
Bien Ventura.
Yeah, the guy said they're pretty good as a daily, as a relatively cheap smoke.
Why don't you keep your eyes on the wheels there, boss, okay? All right? We don't want to get picked up on our way out here.
Cigar guy?
Yeah.
Cigar shop? Yeah. He said the perfect humidity and temperature is 70-70, so he said it is. His pants is where it's where it's
fucking mine. Whoa. Where'd you get these?
Governors.
Did you smoke anything there?
No, I just went in and out. And they have these boxes, and you dig through them and you find junk and you buy it. And they'll have like $3 Mondays, $4 Tuesdays, and I think Fridays are those expensive at like $6 or $7.
What can I give for you?
Hey there, can I get a large coffee with two creams, two sugars?
Alright.
And a large Dr. Pepper.
Alright, anything else?
This would be all.
Alright, your total is $306.
Alright, thank you. And what do you call those things that feed hogs? Troughs.
Uh-huh.
Hogs or troughs, and you go in there and you see people like digging in, they're like, oh my gosh. Mm. $2 headband. Usually they're $1 or $3 somewhere else. Like, I gotta buy it. And then you and you
you go in there and you feel a little sad that you're there.
Yep.
But then you feel sad that you're not alone, which actually makes you happy.
How's it going?
See, pallet stacks liquidation, bin mania. Brands you want, prices you love. Bin pricing, Friday $6, Saturday $5, Monday $3, Tuesday $2, Wednesday. Look, 50 cents on the end there.
Oh man.
And you go in there and it's just like,
we're gonna come here on a Monday, dude.
So anyway, they're closed, but otherwise
we'd be there.
I mean, look at it.
Oh, Thursday, I mean. Look at that.
Whipsaw UTV. And that's it, man. That's the thing now. It's like, hey, what can we... We don't care about aesthetics anymore. Just buy crap. Just buy it.
Mm-hmm.
And leave the store.
What have you been feeding this kid?
All right, look.
I mean...
I'm going to tell you this right now. He's in the crawl space, so once I get in... I'm gonna take him to the room that's
next to. I can't go down this depth.
Well, I gotta take him out anyway. He's probably pretty cold. He had a jacket on, and I'm sure he's wanting for some food.
Yeah, I would imagine so. You know, if you get kidnapped, probably you're pretty hungry. Is this the place right here?
This is the place I've had for a little bit now, and he should be in there. And
well, I'd hope so.
All right, so
well, you go in and
let me go in, do get him out of there, and then you know, we'll go from there.
Cool.
Sure. Okay.
So, what are you doing?
Oh my gosh, it really is, kid. Is he alive?
He should be.
Do you know his name?
What do you think we should call him?
I think we should call him Ted.
Ted?
Yeah, okay. Ted's a rule.
Alright.
First off, I'm sorry that what's happened to you has I got your device. I got your phone here, so you don't have to worry about it.
Don't you go looking for it.
Don't go looking for
it. Don't you look for it.
Look. I have to ask you, I know you've been down in that crawl space for a little bit. Are you a little more comfortable right now? Okay, well, are you hungry? Do you want anything to eat?
Yeah.
What would you like to eat?
Pop-Tarts.
Pop-Tarts.
What kind of food are you growing up on, kid? That's why you're so scrawny.
This is what this is all about, really, you know? It's like, there's this thing called conflict of generations, right? The conflict is the one I want to get down to is that I feel like your generation just isn't in touch with reality. Mm. It's like, you know, you should have asked for steak and mashed potatoes or something. But
he had to get picked up, and the thing is, I know you're just one person. You're probably thinking to yourself, like, man, why me? Why did this happen to me? And I just want you to know that's nothing personal. Nothing
personal, Ted. You play your cards right, you'll be back on Instagram by this time tomorrow.
Yeah. And look, it's like this. I feel that by teaching you
mm-hmm.
a lesson,
yep.
we could teach all kids a lesson through you. Like, I know you have a... Like, the day I picked you up, you had, like, you're doing your TikTok thing. You had your TikTok followers and all that. And I'm thinking, hey, maybe you can share this knowledge with your followers and stuff. So which you're going to do. There's going to be no negotiating about it. Oh, I forgot my mask.
Yeah, he hasn't.
You didn't see my face, did you?
You haven't seen our face, have you?
Did you see?
Saw our face?
Our face.
What do I look like? Describe me right now.
You have a beard.
Uh-huh.
See, the conflict of generation is like, it's like something that I kind of had with, you know, my dad and the older generation, where it's like, you know, the younger generation doesn't have any respect for the elderly anymore. But I think your generation is actually, this is a much more severe case, which is your generation, I don't even think is starting to lose touch with reality.
Mm-hmm.
I don't even think you remember a time where you didn't have a cell phone or the internet. Mm-hmm. Your generation grew up with the internet, man.
Mm.
See?
It's true.
We actually used to run around outside when we were young.
Yeah.
And play and like do stuff with like reality, with nature, you know?
Yeah, look.
And let me ask you a question. How many hours do you think you've logged last week of...
17.
How many sticks do you own?
Yeah, how many selfie sticks do you own? How many ring lights?
Mm-hmm. Huh?
Huh?
23.
How many ring lights 23? Do you own?
23.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay, so look. The older generation says, hey, man. You guys,
hey, look, man.
You guys don't have any respect for the older generation. You guys don't know what it's like to work. You guys don't know what reality is.
Hey, do you have a job?
Yeah. And see,
you don't have a job. How old are you?
12.
12? At 12, I had 3 jobs.
Yeah, exactly.
3 jobs. Okay.
So,
do you know what a job is? What's a job?
You work to get paid.
Mm. And what do you want to do when you grow up?
He's doing it.
Huh?
He's got your TikTok.
What do you
want to
do?
Right?
You want to be a YouTuber? Yeah. You want to be famous on the web? Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Classic. And this is the conflict. You see, we're growing up. You guys are growing up, and you're gonna grow up in a time where you won't ever know what it's not like to have the virtual reality world that you guys love so much. And I think we're gonna have to teach you guys a little lesson.
Mm-hmm.
So now I understand that you probably have to like call your parents or something, and I'll take care of that. We'll take care of that. But
what are you looking for, bud? Are we gonna kill him? Should we kill him?
Well, if we do that, we won't be able to teach the kid a lesson.
Okay.
So, you know, if we could just hold on to you for a little bit there, Teddy boy.
We're going to need you to put the mask back on, okay? So you don't see our faces when we walk out of here. You got any family members, Ted?
Yeah.
Yeah. You want to ever see them again?
Ted? That's what we're going to call you.
Ted, you lost touch with reality. Alright.
So,
you think the...
You have to forgive us if we don't have this better planned. I'll be honest, I kind of acted just off the cuff here.
We haven't kidnapped that many people, Ted.
Yeah, you're going to be the first, but the last. And you're going to spread a great message for all current kids and all the generations to come.
We're going to have you do some manual labor.
Yeah.
We're going to have you learn how to drive a stick shift.
Yeah.
You ever done that?
You ever do that?
No. You know what a stick shift is?
I'm 12.
No.
I'm 16.
Oh, okay.
Dude, I was driving a stick shift when I was 7.
Uh-huh. He's got pigs. Where do you think these guns came from?
This was in his glove box. I've never even held a gun before.
I mean, I don't... It's just saying. You know what a checkbook is?
Yeah.
What do you do with it?
You put money on it?
No. Wrong. You know what an axe is? You know what an axe does? Have you ever seen an axe? Have you ever held an axe? Do you know how to chop wood?
No.
Do you know how to light something?
Yeah.
Yeah, with matches? How about with twiddling sticks?
No.
No? Do you know how to camp? You ever set a tent up? Huh? Do you know the 4 P's of the wilderness? Have you ever seen the sun in Arizona at night?
I've never been to.
I didn't think so. So, I would really, really
consider doing the right thing, okay? If he says jump, I would say how high, all right? Because I've seen him shoot people.
And we're not talking about working out like your thumbs, flipping through apps and stuff and hitting the like button. I mean,
yeah,
we got to have you do some real world stuff, man. Oh, you know, man. It's part of our responsibility. I mean, who would we be if we actually didn't teach you a couple lessons, you know? That wouldn't be cool on our part. We can't just have you like plug into the virtual world and live there forever, you know? Mm-hmm. It wouldn't be cool. Like, it wouldn't be doing right. Do you agree with that, Ted?
Yeah.
Ted.
Okay.
So, I think we're gonna start off with doing a couple, maybe some yard work. Okay. Do you know what a shove? Do you know how to do push-ups?
I don't know.
Show us a couple push-ups real quick. Come on, Ted.
Ted, get down.
I know these aren't virtual world push-ups. We want to see some real push-ups.
Let's go.
Let's see it.
Look at that form. Horrible.
Ted, what happened to your muscle? Your muscles are atrophied, man.
Oh my gosh, Ted, sit it down.
All right, sit down, Ted. I think we can probably do a couple things here. Put him to the test outside, just to get.
Let's get his heart rate up and his blood pumping.
And we'll have to give him some steak. We'll give you some protein because those Pop Tarts and Fruity Pebbles ain't cutting it. All right,
Ted, you stay put.
All right, he should be good.
Was he squirming?
He wasn't too bad, but he is getting hungry. So I figured, you know, eventually we'll have to get him something to eat. Like real food, you know, none of that.
What do you
Keebler
ask
Elf.
For? What do you ask for?
Pop-Tarts.
Pop-Tarts, my goodness. So you think about that, it's like, I've been trying to think, you know, maybe there's not just one thing that has caused society as a whole, at least here in the U.S., to, you know, spiral down into this disconnected misinformation, fake relationship, virtual reality, bullshit, you know, existence that we live right now. Like, that toaster oven, you know, made things happen fast, you know, and then the microwave and... You think about like those advancements and what they did.
Instant gratification, or what's that called? It's like
instant satisfaction, or instant gratification.
Yeah, instant gratification. We're not very well trained anymore in delaying gratification, and we expect results now.
You think about how upset you get when you're not me. Not I've never done this, but people get. When they're at the drive-thru, you know, or they're at the fast food joint and it takes a little while, they mess up their meal.
Yes, I mean, they freak out.
Yeah. I always act, you know, polite and cordial and...
That's because you're a saint.
I'm just, I'm like top-tier saint, but...
Top-tier. Not only are you a saint, you're a top-tier saint.
Well, yeah. I've been doing this for a while. It's a sign of... the times.
Yes, and you might think that I'm wrong in this, or maybe you're with me on this. I'm still not, you know, like, I know you're rolling with this, but it's like, I understand, like, what can we do to go out and try to spread this message among millions of people?
I think we need to kidnap more people.
This was like a total spur of the moment thing. I was... Something just kind of got a hold of me and took control, man. It was actually kind of scary. I thought it was like half joking, but then it became a serious thing. If maybe what we do with this teddy boy here could just kind of, you know, spill out into the rest of the situation that we got going on Earth, then maybe might have an effect, maybe not. But hey, at least maybe we did our part.
You did your part.
You're an accomplice now, man. I'm not involved. I wasn't there.
You're the one who named him.
Oh, man. To send a message, you know? Mm-hmm. You have to make such a big, loud noise to wake, you know, people up in this generation, in this society.
Very loud.
Very loud.
Like kidnapping. Even if you're noisy, it's not heard.
But here's the thing, and the thing that has to sustain us through this is that even if it doesn't get noisy, or make a lot of noise, at least we threw the little pebble in the water, and the ripple effect might be small, but maybe it'll ripple out just enough to maybe do something small over the course of time. But we don't know.
We need to come up with a plan.
Look,
let's go back to my place. Let's take him to your place or my place. I don't know, and come up with a plan. And
you'd be willing to take him out of here?
I mean, you took him here. You can take him out of here. We don't have to do it now.
Well, let's do this. If you're cool with it, let's take him back to your place, since you got the yard and stuff, and we can lock him away downstairs.
Okay.
Because actually, I got him from that part of town.
I mean, if you're cool with that, you're cool with that. And then we'll.
As long as we blindfold him.
It'll only be for a day or two.
And we'll have him do some, balancing a checkbook.
Yes. We'll get him to balance a checkbook. Dig some holes, use a shovel.
Yep.
Change a spark plug or something. Learn how to drive a stick shift. Do you have something that stick shift?
No, but I do have a vehicle that he could work on.
Perfect.
Might as well make something out of this.
Right.
We'll have him start a fire.
Mm. And beyond that, you know, kill a deer.
Gut it,
cook some venison up. Like a steak, venison, that'd be great.
All right, we'll go get him.
All right. Let me just catch my breath.
How old is that kid?
He said he was 12, remember?
No, I don't remember a thing about it. Props? Not props, but you know, the stuff we need. Sure is cold up here in the Rockies.
Yeah. Probably get another 8 inches tonight. I'm not talking about snow either.
Here
we go. I don't see any Pop-Tarts.
This is he? I don't know. What do you think? I mean, well, you might be like, you might be a frosted strawberry. You might be a chocolate fudge. Let's get a frosted chocolate fudge too. All right.
Do you believe in life after love?
Dude? I do. Not after love, I. How
we going? Every few seconds, there's something else to grab your attention. And you will keep scrolling, because sometimes you see something you like, and sometimes you don't. And that differentiation, which is very similar to a slot machine in Vegas, is key. In psychological terms, called random reinforcement. It means sometimes you win, sometimes you lose, and that's how the platform is designed, so that you continue to seek. However, unlike a slot machine, you'll never run out of money to play with. Theoretically, you could continue to scroll forever, and your For You page would never run out of content. Like the name suggests, it would continue to pick out the perfect content and place them in an order completely personalized and tailored to keep you engaged within the app. Have you ever stopped and given some critical thought to what TikTok is showing you? Probably not. In fact,
Over 97% of users who were surveyed could not remember what TikTok video they had seen after just 30 seconds of continuing to scroll. TikTok is numbing your mind, and in turn, causing irreversible brain damage.
Hi, can I help you? Hey there, my name is Conrad. I am the person responsible for your son going missing. Look, I know, you're scared. Rest assured, he's okay. If you haven't called the cops, please don't. I'm just gonna teach him a few more lessons and I will have him back to you as soon as possible, okay? Thanks a lot for your cooperation. Have a great day.
You know what these are, and you can recite it from memory, okay? You got the four P's of the wilderness. Pretty much anybody that goes camping knows these P's and can recite them to you in their sleep, okay? So we got protect,
produce,
predict,
pop off.
Okay?
Repeat them.
What is produce?
Protect, produce, predict, pop off.
Now listen, what I want you to do is, I want you to dig into that snow and move it onto that big pile right there, okay?
You ever used a shovel before?
All right.
Just shut your mouth and say it. Pop off. Okay.
You gotta protect. What is it that you're protecting? Well, you're protecting yourself, you're protecting your gear, you're protecting Mother Nature.
All right, buddy boy. You know what this is? It's a box. Matches. You ever seen matches before?
You ever seen matches, buddy?
Huh? What you do is you flick it and you open it. Flick it and you open it. These little sticks right here. See the red tip? See this little light here? This little sandpaper? Boom! See that? Fire. Okay? Gotta have the right pressure, the right speed.
You need to get that going. What do you think when you see produce? You think produce aisle. You think food. You think production. You think assembly lines and Ford.
You know how to open a hood?
There's gonna be a latch down there somewhere.
So you don't teach yourself on TikTok, do they?
No. There you go.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, lucky you got the hydraulics on this one. Back in the day, we had to prop it up.
See that? See how it says VTEC? That means something, okay?
You know what VTEC means?
That's very tech, very technical, all right?
Put it back into it.
Put it back into it.
Oh, yeah.
There you go. Now start digging a hole. Shovel's got to go down. You're going sideways.
It's your first hole digging experience.
What? Some food for you. Some firewood. Some fun. Some produce anything that you want. Okay? Predict. What do you think I'm going to say with this one? Yes.
You gotta predict when something's gonna come out and eat you!
Yeah!
You don't start a fire,
you're dead. Out here, these temperatures, you're about to go out 22 minutes.
Listen, don't go anywhere, because I got this thing
attached to you, so don't even try it. You got any tools?
Yeah, let's go.
I'm gonna grab you some tools. Hang tight.
All right, look, Teddy. We want you to open that up and grab the vice grips, okay?
Don't get any funny ideas, all right?
Yeah, no funny ideas.
Grab the vice grips.
Grab the vice grips, dude.
Wrong.
Ah, finally. Nice job.
Right, now put those up. You don't need them.
Now grab the Phillips head and let's get going.
All right, you see that orange thing over there, that orange tag?
I want you to pull it up.
Yep.
Oh, like a man.
Okay, look. Tom, what are you showing? This is one of the CSPs right here. This is the chat, okay? So first thing you're going to want to do is you're going to write, hey, to the order of who?
You're going to have to say goodbye to that stuff right there, okay? You're not getting that ring light, are you? Come on, you want that ring light, don't you?
Whoa.
Hey, no dancing, buddy.
I know what you must be thinking, Ted.
You must be thinking, it's time for lunch, and it's not.
You got to use more than your thumb strength.
What are you doing? There you go. Oh, yeah, put the screwdriver back. That's called a dipstick, all right? You dipstick. Topper, okay? All right, put it down in there like you mean it. Seal it.
Okay.
Perfect. All right, now, whoa, look at you, strong guy.
Count, you gotta put, how much you paying? You gotta put 50 bucks.
50, no.
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 No, hey.
Don't be a dummy.
50. Right. Look at that, ooh, you don't get it. No, you don't get it.
Oh, I think I hear your phone vibrating.
Uh-oh, we hear your phone vibrating?
I think your phone vibrating.
Is that one of your?
Why not a lighter?
Hey, don't ask questions, we give the questions.
Well, you can't drop them in the water.
Hey, we ask the questions right here.
Get closer. Are you afraid of fire?
What did fire ever do to you, huh?
You think you're gonna get
bit or something?
There you go.
You don't know. You gotta predict these things. You gotta be prepared.
Pop off?
Oh, man.
Now listen, you can't pop off
if you don't have something to pop off with. All right, now what I want you to do is, I want you to get the monkey wrench out of here, okay? The custom wrench, any one of them. Now, what I want you to do is, I want you to start taking off the master cylinder head. Okay?
Oh, look, buddy, you hungry?
Look, it's lunch time.
Oh, yeah, go ahead and have it.
Try to
see what it tastes like.
Try to think about it.
Is it good?
I bet. Cool. I've ever seen in my life.
Yeah, that's not that too good of a hole. What am I going to do with this hole? You're doing a whole lot of nothing.
Yeah.
You're making a whole lot of mess.
Whole lot of nothing there, Teddy.
There you go.
Why
don't you quit digging into the side of this thing? All right. Blow it out.
You know how to bore out cylinders? Okay, you're about to find out.
Show me where the engine is.
Okay.
See where the air intake is? No. That's the exhaust manifold, okay? This is a V12. No. That's the coolant. Keep it cool. There we go. That's the throttle body, baby. That's where the air comes in and gooses it, all right? Now, I need you to disconnect that.
And when you need to, and the opportunity presents itself, all right, buddy, you pop off.
Now, put the snow back in the hole.
There, huh? You think you're going to get popped
anymore? Yeah, I'm going to get a reward. All right, that's it. He needs to take the time out.
Come on.
How about some,
huh?
That's what you need to be eating, okay? We're gonna be here for a while.
Oh, man. There you go.
All right. Whoa, easy there. Nope, that's good. You got it. All right, put it back. Cook it, all right? You see this? See those? Pepperonis. All right, go ahead and get some of those in your body.
If it's not cooked, you gotta eat it raw.
Yeah.
Like a man.
Let's see you eat some of that pepperoni.
Eat the pepperoni. All right. We're gonna tie you off, we're gonna come back, and this thing's better be roaring, okay? Roaring.
With a smile.
Yeah, bud, that's real meat right there. That's gonna get strong. Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Do you want some of this? Do you want to get your TikTok notification?
Do a little clay pigeon shoot with this thing?
That's cholesterol.
And what's in this?
Nothing. Nothing.
Liking that new stuff, huh? I never had that before, have you?
Yeah, he hasn't eaten in 3 days, so.
Mm-hmm.
We can't let Caleb run over this like this. Oh, yeah. All
right, so tell them what they are for memory. Go. Yeah.
Papa.
There we go.
Nice job.
All right.
High five.
Well done. I think you're going to make it out there, buddy. I think you're going to make it.
Pace from one micro-length video to another shortens your attention span. You must attend to a given stimulus for a mere 15 seconds, and then another one appears, and another one, and another. What effect does this have on your brain? In simplest terms, it melts it. Due to the overwhelming amount of stimuli presented to you in such a short time span, two things will happen. The first is that your neurons will begin to break down, leaving clusters of dead cells in your brain. The second is that your hippocampus, the part of your brain that plays an important role in memory, will begin to shrink. If that doesn't scare you, it should. Both of these are the leading causes of Alzheimer's, a disease that destroys your ability to recall old memories and to create new ones. And the worst part? There's no known cure. For a young person whose brain is still developing, these effects are even worse. You probably didn't know this, but your brain isn't fully developed until you reach 25 years old. Those who spend too much time on TikTok before their brains are finished growing increase their chances of getting degenerative brain diseases by over 4,000%. And what's even worse is that the effects will begin to show at a younger age. While diseases like Alzheimer's normally start to show signs at around 60 years old, those whose minds have been heavily impacted by TikTok could begin to exhibit signs by the time they're only 30 and have their brain completely shut off by the time they're just 40. So, the next time you think of using TikTok, please just ask yourself, is watching a few short videos to kill time worth cutting your life short by killing your brain? Because that's exactly what you're doing every time you open the app. Thanks for watching.
Well, this concludes our broadcast day.
Well, I think, I don't really know what else to do with Teddy Boy.
Well, here's the thing. What? We don't want to go to jail for nothing. So, you know, we might as well go out with a bang and make some noise, make a lot of noise, you know?
Well, how do you suggest we do that?
I think we need to make sure Teddy has learned his lesson.
There's really no way to force him.
Well,
to, like,
I wasn't finished.
Post.
I wasn't finished.
Or ask him to.
Then we
expect him to.
We'll take a picture of his ID. He doesn't have one, but we'll take a picture of it.
We'll get his face.
We'll tell him that we're going to kill his family if he tells anybody. And that he's got to spend the rest of his life dedicated to
Jesus.
You know, to changing his generation. And if he doesn't, and if he fails, you know, he's dead.
Yeah. Along with the rest of society.
Well, you dug a hole, worked on the car, did a few more things. I think we release him into the wild and we tell him that he needs to make his post about things that matter, you know? And if he doesn't, he's gone. And we should drop him off, like, somewhere unfamiliar to him, so he has to work at getting home.
In the cold at night.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I mean, hopefully the message gets across. Hopefully he found some good in what we had to show him. And you know, I mean, the whole idea here is get out there, buddy, and enjoy the real world. Enjoy God's creations, man.
Yeah.
Otherwise, him along with everybody else in his generation, the people to come, they're just gonna be it's gonna be the Matrix, man.
Yeah.
They're going to be tapped in forever. They won't be able to distinguish that from this.
Yeah.
And if Teddy Boy doesn't pick up on that soon, if he hasn't already, then, you know, God bless his soul.
I think the dream world is supposed to have an effect on how we live our actual lives when we're awake, not vice versa. I mean, I feel like this next generation is living more in the dream world and neglecting the real boots on the ground here, you know,
mm-hmm.
reality. They're escaping for, they're trading what's real for something superficial, and it's going to be too late when they realize it, except for Teddy Boy. We saved him. I mean, that's, I guess, mission complete, you know, you save one. We did our job.
Well, look, first off, I want to say thank you for not reporting me to the police and rolling with the bunches here. And I want to thank you for, if Teddy does decide to go to the authorities, I want to thank you in advance for taking the heat for us. Either you're never aware.
Exactly.
Right.
That's my point.
Cool, man.
Well, hey, I think it was all in all, it was a pretty good hostage situation. I mean, Teddy was a pretty good guest, and we got some work done at my place.
We could get some ransom.
I don't think he's worth that much, man.
He's worth the cause, but he's probably not worth much himself.
Yeah, no.
All right.
All right, Teddy, look, unfortunately, we wanted to teach you a lot more things, but you know, time restricts. You know, you're getting older by the minute, and we think it's time for you to go back into the wild, even though there's still a lot of things you have to learn. Yeah. But
and you didn't do that well, but
yeah, okay. Not to mention that you didn't do too great. But hey, I think we're getting the point across, yeah?
Yeah.
And I really...
A couple
really,
more of these will be... We'll be there.
Yeah. Really wanted you to get on that stick shift and do a few more things. Hunt, but deer season's over. So what do you think, man? You think he's good? He's not good.
I'm hopeful.
We're hopeful, Teddy, that you can go out and...
Spread the word.
Teach the other generations of to come the lessons that you learned.
Yeah.
In the last few days. What manual labor is. And I noticed that you really haven't been talking about your phone much, which is good.
Yeah.
You know, the ring light's gone. We trashed that. Mm. So.
Here's the thing. We need to know that you're not going to tell anybody who we are.
Yeah.
Okay. And the only way that we can do that is by threatening you.
Yeah.
And that's what we're doing right now. We know where you live. And we know what you eat.
Yeah.
So you tell anybody, you're pretty much dead.
And if we find you at the store, the Pop-Tart section, you know what's gonna happen, right?
Mm.
You're gonna lose your limbs.
Limbs gone. Which ones? We don't know. Maybe one of each.
Thumbs go first for sure.
Yeah.
And your indexes so that you can't pick your nose and eat your burgers anymore. So Teddy, go ahead and put on your jacket.
You ever seen the catch and release program?
Nice and slow. We don't want you pulling any tricks.
You ever been fishing before?
Mm-hmm.
Hey, Teddy, have you ever been fishing?
Yeah. Because we can fry you up. We can fry you up and have you for dinner.
Because listen, you catch a fish, okay? You think he likes having that hook in his mouth? No, he doesn't. And then you think he likes getting pulled out of the water? No. It's not fun. But guess what? It's fun for the fisher. Fish gets put right back into the wild. Right back into his natural habitat. But guess what? He'll always have a hole in his mouth. As a reminder, easy does it, buddy.
We'll head you out the front door.
Okay, buddy, this is the end of the line.
It was good knowing you, man.
This is where you get out.
Hopefully you don't do anything stupid, you know?
Better not see you out here TikToking again.
All right.
It was nice knowing you, buddy.
Hey, man. Thanks for your, you know, your...
cooperation.
Yeah, cooperation.
And, hey, don't forget we know where you live.
Yeah. And if you want your tripod, it's right there. Otherwise, I'm keeping it. And your ring lights back there, too. And your tripod bag.
Good riddance.
Good riddance.
Thank you.
There he goes, man.
Yeah? Yeah? I don't know where you are. I think there's a town about a few miles that way. I'm sure you'll find some people there.
Why don't you use your TikTok fan base? Ask them.
I forgot through to him. Cute kid, though.
Yeah. I mean, a real sweetheart.
Hold on. Looks like he wants something.
You know how to get home?
You want
to
come back with us?
Teddy! Do you want bus money?
There he goes, man.
All right. Another one bites the dust. Let's go grab another kid.
I want you to start looking for something. And I promise you, once you start looking for it, you'll never be able to stop seeing it everywhere you go. When's the last time you've walked into a restaurant and saw an entire table of friends on their phone, or a group of people on the street, or maybe even your family in the morning, each content to be in their own world, nearly unaware of the reality around them? If the majority of human interaction is nonverbal, what would happen if you removed everything but that small remainder for over a decade? As it turns out, that's the very experiment that we're living in today. I remember when I was growing up, way back in the day, a prehistoric time before everyone had a cell phone and computers were named after the year they were made in. Okay, I'm not quite a dinosaur yet, but I grew up in a unique time where half of my childhood was without the major technology and platforms that seem to rule parts of our lives today, and the other half of my childhood was rapidly slingshotted into the new age of technology. I remember from the earlier half of my childhood, life seemed different, especially human interaction. If you wanted to talk with someone, you had no other option but to physically go out and find them and spend uninterrupted time with them in the same room. And while you were there, there was nothing pulling your attention away, nothing in the back of your mind reminding you that there are hundreds of other people sharing information that you might be missing out on. That degree of presence, practiced day in and day out, created a different richness to human interaction, with intricacies and nuances that seems to be slowly and gradually lost the further we progress into this new age of technological advancement. And with the meteoric rise in popularity for documentaries like The Social Dilemma, it's safe to say that this is a growing sentiment and realization within today's culture. The terrifying crux to the problem is actually quite simple. There's a massive mismatch between the rate of adaptation and advancement between our biology and technology. Because of the law of accelerating returns, the pace of advancement in information technology is exponential. And while technology continues to grow at a rapid pace, we're left still trying to figure out how it actually impacts us, especially when we're teaching algorithms to predict and modulate our behavior. I don't think that anyone's denying that social media, as well as instant communication, is extremely addictive, and its addiction falls right within the same symptoms as substance abuse. But what we don't quite know yet is how this addiction over time changes not only our behaviors through hacking our positive reinforcement centers of the brain, but how over time it changes our perception of reality itself. When we first embarked upon the social media experiment, we had far more in-person interactions under our belt than we did interactions online. So we took our in-person frame of reference and viewed all of our technological interactions through that lens. But now, in a time when we have hundreds, even thousands of friends, acquaintances, celebrities, and online personalities that we keep up with online, we have slowly over time replaced the majority of our interactions with being digital. how much do we now view our in-person interactions through our new digital lens? As a prominent example, you can look at our growingly polarized political discourse in modern times, and you see that we've already started to see the symptoms of a very binary interpretation of human interaction. It's also worrisome to think that our upcoming generation's digital presence may end up being more important than their in-person presence. So how do we stop all of this from happening? Is the answer to shut it all down, just pull the plug on big tech? I don't think that it is. The truth is, we've opened Pandora's box, and this is the reality that we're now faced with. So what's the path forward? The first step is underway, awareness. Much of classical conditioning, and if you don't know what that is, Pavlov's dogs might ring a bell, is based on the more non-conscious mechanisms of the brain. If you become conscious of how the conditioning is affecting you, it gives you a degree of control over your behavior. Beyond that, it's important to maintain that balance of in-person and digital interaction. You want the lens that you view the world from to be a full 100% of human communication. Body language, emotion, facial expression, nuanced tonality. It's what we were designed to do, and we can't let that practice atrophy, because that's what creates our sense of identity and community that gives us a healthy view of others in the world. If we can maintain that balance, we can begin to have a healthier relationship with our online presence and retain control over the influence these platforms and technologies have on us. These algorithms are based on human behavior and response, and that's something we have control over. Take some small steps today. Maybe start by uninstalling some social media platforms from your phone. Then you have to physically go log into your computer to use it, removing some of the convenience. If you're tied to your phone for work, once the day is done, find some time to spend with your family and friends, and turn your phone completely off for it. Be fully present with the people that you're with. And you just might notice that the world isn't quite as crazy as it seems, and that the life right in front of you is beautiful.
Considered a flood zone? Flood zone's like a zone that floods.
Oh, that makes sense. A lot of cars here on these streets.
What are you smoking these days?
This is a Oliva B. She's nice, she's pretty.
What do you like about it?
I like how it smokes.
Yeah, so, you know, I went to this Coda place once before, and you know what they do there?
Transport people?
No. Yeah, that's what they tell you that they do. They sacrifice.
Oh, man.
Animals. They drink the blood.
That's kind of messed up. Places. I mean, it's like building after building just came up.
It's crazy. It is crazy.
Oh, I mean, what? What? Stop. Stop the car.
What?
Dude, stop the car.
What? What do you see?
There's no way. There's a kid over there in a black coat with a hoodie on in front of a tripod.
Are you kidding me?
No, I'm not. It looks exactly like Teddy.
Oh my gosh.
What are the odds?
I swear, dude. If you're not... Are you joking or are you being serious?
No, dude.
Where?
Right over there. By that pond. All right. Corner of the building.
Let me turn around.
Dude, what?
Are you sure?
No.
All right.
We're going to find out. It wouldn't surprise me.
Well, it would me, man. I mean, the freaking kid. Do we not... Do what we had to do?
He was the brightest kid I've ever met. You know?
Jeez, man.
I mean, I know it's only been a little while, but he looks exactly like him.
No way, man. If that's him, I will go nuts. No, he's not on it.
Dude.
That's him.
That's Teddy.
That's him.
He's doing it.
Teddy? Ted! What did we tell you?
here, Teddy.
Hey!
Remember the four P's!